Mabel, welcome to Kiss Breakfast. Babe, I am so excited to be talking about new music with you. Let Them Know is your latest single. Yeah. And it is a feel-good self-love banger.
Yes!
How are you feeling about it? What does it mean to you?
I am just so excited. When you said you're excited to be talking about new music, I'm like, I'm excited to be talking about new music. I took my time. I needed some time. Because it was a whirlwind of madness and amazingness around the Don't Pull Me Up and High Expectations era. But I was like, this is it. Album two, playing no games. Like, what are we going to do? I want a direction. And just spent like the first sort of lockdown listening to music and got really obsessed with like Madonna, like Vogue especially. And was just like, I just want to carry on making music that's going to make people feel good. But I guess there's a personal journey that I've been on, which the deeper meaning of the song kind of lies in, which is just about like being fearless about being who you really are. I think like looking at social media and whether you're an artist or not an artist, sort of thinking that you need to be this one thing, and it's exhausting trying to be something that you're not. And I'm so sick of it. And I just want to encourage everybody to like be the craziness of who they really are, because it feels great.
Literally Let Them Know, because I feel so gassed, because you've always been so wonderful and open on social media about mental health and important stuff that people need to hear. Firstly, I want to touch on the fact, before we go into that, that on your TikTok, I'm obsessed with your TikTok, but the last video you did made me absolutely die, because we all have those moments in life where we make a doozy.
Oh,
right. But the thing is, I love that Let Them Know is not just Let Them Know like I am a bad bee, I am
no,
but it's also, yeah, sometimes my boob accidentally falls out on stage or
right in front of 5,000 people and the camera zooming in. I'm fine though. Let Them Know.
No, but Let Them Know, because we've all been at the bottom of a water slide with our bikini at the top, hun.
Do you like, know what I mean? It happens. It happens to the best of us. And I hate, nothing stresses me out more than the idea of like young people looking at my Instagram and thinking that I'm perfect, because I'm really not. And that is not like, that is not why I'm here. Like, that is not why I'm here. Like, it takes a lot of hair and makeup to like step out the way that you not see me step out. Like, it's not that. And I don't just want to show you that. And Let Them Know is really about embracing all the parts of yourself and just like being proud of that. Like, for me, I'm like, it's equally as important that I wake up in the morning and I have morning breath and my weave is all over the place and I'm still letting them know.
Yes, because we're human beings. Like,
right.
I feel like on Instagram I'm the weirdest that I could possibly be, because I just don't want anyone to think I'm not weird, in case, like, I feel like an alien most of the time anyway. And I think on social media it's so important to show the true you. But how do you sort of manage the mental health side of social media?
It's still difficult. Like, obviously, I didn't have social media really before I started doing music, because I always felt like an alien in school. So I didn't have social media and stuff, and then started doing music. And obviously, it's an amazing tool to be able to communicate with my fans. And I got into it, started figuring it out. Then it sort of took over and I took it too far, because I just felt like I was on there all the time. And you're sort of like, these people love me. Oh, no, wait, now these people hate me. And I'm like, and you're just constantly searching for that validation. And you can get 200 amazing comments and I get one bad one that's like, I know isn't true, and it will literally send me. And I think that journey that I've been talking about, that it took to get to Let Them Know, where I was just like, this is who I am, this is how I'm gonna dress, my hair's orange, I talk too much, I'm insane. I am being proud of that with social media as well. I'm just like, I know now, I can be honest with myself and be like, do you know what, today I can't hack it. And then some days I'm like, this is great and I have fun with it. And I think it's just about, I guess I try to raise more awareness to people that it's like, it's not normal to be looking at other people's lives as much as we do. And also we're not, you're seeing somebody's highlights. And it worries me, especially for like teenagers, when that's already such a difficult time, literally being 14, like, wow, big up you if you're 14.
I think that idea as well, that it's just a highlight reel. I post more when I'm sad. I post more, like I'm more funny on Instagram when I'm having an awful time. So it really doesn't prove anything.
No, it doesn't prove anything. Also, yeah, I tend to, if I'm like going through a breakup or somebody's, you know, I'll be like doing the absolute most on Instagram. Yeah, I'm like, everything's great. And I think
I love being single.
Single is great. I don't know. It's just dangerous, isn't it? Like, I love that I can talk to my fans and have that communication with them. But also, I think it's not necessarily good for all of us to be on there all day, every day, is it?
No, but I think you've got a really healthy relationship. And I just want to quickly touch on, by the way, you mentioned your hair. We're having a little Jerry Halliwell moment, and I am obsessed.
I mean, obviously, I'm a Jerry stan. As you can see, I mean, I really took it all the way there with the orange and the blonde streaks. I just thought, you know what? I'm all about having fun at the moment. And I just think, have fun with the hair. I've been wearing lots of colourful clothes. Like, it's very much I walk into a room now and everybody's like, okay, cool.
I'm honestly so excited for this new moment. You've called it a new era. We've had the Renaissance, we've had the Roaring Twenties, we've had Baroque, we've had Romantic. But what is the new era for Mabel called?
I feel like it's freedom, honey. Oh. It's freedom. Do you know what I mean? We've all been locked in, you know, everybody wants to dance. Just, you know, feel the music, good vibes, energy. But I also feel like there's like a symbolic thing of like what we were talking about, like really being yourself and just like not caring about what other people think. That is so freeing. So yes,
this makes me so happy, and I just love to hear that you've had a little bit of time away to really focus on what you love.
Yeah,
and I am so excited to enjoy listening to that, because I feel like when an artist really goes into what they love and care about when it comes to music, it just melts out of the music, and you can hear it and let them know, like, the energy, the power, the bad B energy behind this is just really exciting, and I'm so looking forward to seeing what happens next.
Thank you, babe.